Okay, so I think last time we had discussed about uncracked section. Uncracked section, this was already over. Okay, now we come to the second part, that is the analysis of cracked section. Okay, cracked section is what we are going to see today. Okay. About cracked section, one thing that we can say for sure is the applied moment is certainly more than the cracking moment. Okay, we have already discussed about this cracking moment. Okay, so whatever moment you have applied here is more than the cracking moment. Now, moving on. About cracked section, you should first understand that now your neutral axis is not located at CG. Okay, since your section is cracked, what has happened here is, suppose this is your section, okay, this is your section and it has cracked from here. Your neutral axis is somewhere around here. What will happen is only this much concrete is effective now. All the concrete below neutral axis, okay, is not going to take any tension. That is our basic assumption. No tension it will take. So this much area of concrete is useless. This is the reason why your neutral axis is no more located at CG. How will you determine that neutral axis then? Neutral axis is now determined by equilibrium. Equilibrium of forces. ठीक है? So our first question should be, how will you calculate the neutral axis? Okay. Suppose we have a section something like this. Okay, something like this. Okay, you will have some steel here. Suppose I'm saying we have AST amount of steel. This is your B. Okay, this here is your D. Okay, and this is your overall depth. Okay, what I will do, I will just transform this section. Transform. Okay, if I transform this section, okay, if I transform this section, I will get something like this. बोलो
अभी चाहिए
नहीं चाहिए
अभी
ओके समथिंग लाइक दिस वी विल गेट ओके बट द प्रॉब्लम हियर इज सपोज दैट माय न्यूट्रल एक्सिस इज हियर माय न्यूट्रल एक्सिस इज हियर दिस मच कंट्रीब्यूटिंग एरिया दिस मच एरिया इज नॉट कंट्रीब्यूटिंग सिंस दिस मच एरिया इज नॉट कंट्रीब्यूटिंग वॉट वी कैन डू हियर इज we can simply do what we can simply draw this area like this okay and you will have your steel here so your effective area is this above neutral axis concrete and this much amount of steel this you already know this is transform section so this is MST now you don't need M minus 1 okay this is MST now this is the depth of your neutral axis okay this is the depth of neutral axis I'm calling it as XU okay moving on if you further draw the stress diagram here I'm drawing the stress diagram here your stress diagram is also linear assumption of WSM okay so here you will be having your FCBC that is the stress in concrete here suppose FST is the stress in steel So this stress in concrete will be FST upon M. I think we have already discussed this, how it is coming FST upon M. I have already told you this. I have already told you this. Suppose you know the stress in concrete. Suppose stress in concrete is FC. Okay, and you want to know the stress in steel. So it will be M times of FC. It is very similar to that. Now this part, this area here, this area representing as concrete, we have transformed the section. So the stress that is here is FST by M. Okay, FST by M. Now, moving on. If you see the force diagram now, force diagram, this much area is in compression, okay, this much area for XU, and here somewhere steel is located, steel will be providing you tension, this is your compression, and between steel compression and tension, this part, this is your lever arm, lever arm. Is this okay? Is this okay? Okay, this we have already discussed, this is SCVC. Okay, now I want to write compression force. Compression force, what is compression force? This area, okay, this area compression force, it is equal to half FCVC XU into B. Is this okay? Is this okay? What is your tension force? Look at this, the stress, this much amount of stress is there, and what is the area? MAST, M and M will get cancelled, it is equal to FST into AST. This is your tension force. Okay, I have already told you one thing, that your neutral axis will now be coming from equilibrium, your compression is equal to tension. Okay, equilibrium equation, basic equilibrium equation. What is your compression? Compression is half CVC BXU, and this is equal to FST into AST. This is your basic equation that you will use to calculate your neutral axis. Neutral axis. Now, if you notice in this equation, you notice something in this equation, okay, what are things that you already know? What are the things that you already know? Do you know this is a constant? Do you know this value? No. You know this? Yes. You know this? No. You know this? No. You know this? Yes. So 1, 2, 3. 3 unknowns in one equation. Okay? Won't be able to solve it. You won't be able to solve it. Okay? For that, what we do here is, you again see the stress diagram. Stress diagram is something like this. Somewhere here, this is your XU, this is your FCVC, okay, this is your FST by M, okay, and this much is D minus XU. Okay, if you use similarity of triangle, you use similarity of triangle, this is your first triangle and this is your second triangle, this one, okay. So if you use similarity of triangle, what you will get? FCVC upon XU is equal to FST upon M divided by D minus XU. Okay, this is what you will get. Now, what is this implying? Suppose I want to calculate this ratio. Okay, what is this ratio will come out to be? XU upon M D minus XU. Isn't it? Now you look at this equation. Can you create the ratio FCVC upon FST here? Yes, you can. If you rewrite this equation, I'm writing it here. FCVC upon FST is equal to 2 AST upon BXU. And this part we have just calculated here. So I'm writing it with a different color. Okay. This part will be equal to XU upon M D minus XU. You look at this equation now. Again, you look at this equation. You know this. This is constant. You know M. You know D. Only thing that is unknown is XU. It can be solved. Is it okay? Okay, it can be solved for XU. So this is how you will get the neutral axis. That is the most important part. Okay. Second thing that is asked in these type of questions is, what is the MOR? That is the moment of resistance, maximum moment of रेजिस्टेंस, ठीक है। टू फाइंड मोमेंट ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस वी विल हैव थ्री थॉट्स। फर्स्ट, स्टील स्टील मे यील्ड बिफोर कॉन्क्रीट फेल्स, ओके। सेकेंड कैन बी योर कॉन्क्रीट मे फेल बिफोर स्टील यील्ड्स। थर्ड इज बोथ फेल साइमल्टेनियसली, ओके। देर आर थ्री पॉसिबिलिटीज, ओके। दीज आर द थ्री पॉसिबिलिटीज दैट वी हैव, ओके। दिस वन हियर बोथ आर फेलिंग साइमल्टेनियसली, दिस इज सजेस्टिंग दैट योर फेलियर इज बैलेंस्ड, ओके। द फेलियर इज बैलेंस्ड। दिस वन इज सजेस्टिंग दैट योर फेलियर इज ओवर रेनफोर्स्ड, एंड दिस हियर इज सजेस्टिंग दैट योर फेलियर इज अंडर रेनफोर्स्ड, ओके। योर फेलियर इज अंडर रेनफोर्स्ड। मूविंग ऑन सपोज आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट बैलेंस्ड फेलियर, ओके। बैलेंस्ड फेलियर आई एम सेइंग के योर बोथ आर फेलिंग साइमल्टेनियसली, दैट इज व्हेन द स्टील इज यील्डिंग द कॉन्क्रीट इज ऑल्सो गेटिंग क्रश्ड। सो इफ यू ड्रॉ द स्ट्रेन डायग्राम अगेन और स्ट्रेस डायग्राम अगेन, दिस इज योर FCBC, दिस स्ट्रेस हियर एट द लेवल ऑफ स्टील इज FST/M, ओके। दिस इज योर न्यूट्रल एक्सिस, नाउ आई एम कॉलिंग इट एक्स बैलेंस्ड, ओके। बोथ आर फेलिंग साइमल्टेनियसली मीन्स दिस FST इज ऑल्सो रीचिंग इट्स परमिसेबल लिमिट एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो रीचिंग इट्स permissible limit simultaneously, okay. From here you can say that FCBC by X balance is equal to FST by M upon D minus X balance. Here FCBC is obviously equal to sigma CBC and your FST is obviously equal to sigma ST. So let me just write it down here. Okay, let me just write it down here. This is your sigma CBC now, and this is your sigma ST. Give me x balance will be equal to how much? M, I'm writing M, okay. M, if you solve it, you will get this CBC upon M sigma CBC plus sigma ST. Is this okay? Okay, now this is where people make mistake, okay. Let me clarify the mistake. This is where people will make mistake. The question will be asked like this. X balance is dependent on, okay. Your answer should be only sigma ST, okay. Now you will look here and tell me that no, it is dependent on sigma CBC also, M also, sigma CBC also. That is wrong. See, code has already told you your M is equal to 280 by 3 sigma CBC. You put that value here, what you will get here is X balance is equal to D upon 1 plus 3 sigma ST upon 280. You can solve this. This is your final value of X balance. Okay, now you have your neutral axis and you have calculated your X balance, okay. With these two you can tell whether your section is under reinforced or over reinforced or balanced, okay. For example, suppose I have this section here, okay. This is a neutral axis, okay. Somewhere here is X balance. Suppose your X is coming somewhere here. This is your XU. Okay, this is your X balance and this is your XU. Obviously, if your neutral axis has moved in this direction, that means your steel is less, isn't it? So that is implying that your failure will be under reinforced. See, whatever is less will dictate the design. So steel is less, so that will fail first, so it is under reinforced section. Okay, so first thing I am writing here, let me change the color. First thing I am writing here, if your X is less than or XU is less than X balance, it is under reinforced section. Similarly, you can say, okay, if your X is greater than X balance, it is an over reinforced section, and your X is equal to X balance, it is an balanced section. Of course, is this okay? Okay, moving on to our MOR question. What is the MOR? Now you can tell, once you know if your section is under reinforced, you know that steel will dictate, so your moment will be equal to tension into lever arm. That is, your moment will be equal to sigma ST by M into MAST into lever arm. Is how much is the lever arm? We haven't calculated the lever arm yet. So again, you see it is very simple. This is your compression force, somewhere here is your tension. Okay, this is your XU. The CG of this compression force, that is located at XU by 3. Triangle, CG of triangle is 1/3 from here. Okay, so it is XU by 3. We have already said that this is your lever arm, so Z is equal to D minus XU by 3. Is this okay? So this is D minus XU by 3. So finally you will get something like this: sigma ST AST D minus XU by 3. This is your answer when your section is under reinforced. Under reinforced. This is the first case, it is under reinforced. Okay. Moving on to the second case. If you want to note something down, you can just pause the video and not note it down. Okay. Second is your balance section. Of course, balance section is very simple. You can go for either TZ or you can go for CZ. Both will give you equal answer. That is, it is equal to sigma ST AST D minus X balance by 3, or you can write it as sigma CBC by 2 into B X balance D minus X balance by 3. They're both equal. Okay, moving on. Third case, over reinforced. This is slightly tricky. Okay, this is very tricky. Now, if you pay attention in this one is a little tricky. Suppose that to find out neutral axis, I am equating C equal to T. Okay, this is how I found out the neutral axis. Now, from this I will get some X value, I will check it with X balance, I will get something like this, then I will say it is over reinforced. What is the MOR for over reinforced? We know that it is over reinforced, so steel is not yielding, concrete is getting crushed. So I will say sigma CBC by 2 BXU into D minus XU by 3. Is this okay? Okay. Now, what I want to show you here is IS code says that over reinforced section is not allowed. Why over reinforced section is not allowed is pretty simple. You can see that your steel is not yielding and your concrete is getting crushed. Okay, since your concrete is getting crushed, you always know that concrete crushing is a brittle failure. Since it is a brittle failure, it will happen suddenly without any warning. So that is what code says, that without any warning, sudden failure is not acceptable and over reinforced section should not be designed. Okay, But if some section is already given to you, which is over reinforced, you can use this, you can use this thing, you can use this thing to answer, even though IS code says that this is not allowed. Okay, is this okay? This is all about the theory part. Okay, now we'll move on to the question. We'll do this one question and your singly reinforced will be over. You'll be able to understand the theory better. This is a question. We just read the question once and then we'll start. Okay, let's move on. So what is given to you is a singly reinforced section. This is the section here. Okay, we are given to be M20 and FE415. Okay, width is given to you, effective depth is given to you, and steel is given to you. Okay, this much is given to you. First question that we are focusing on is what is the cracking moment. In RCC, you don't have to practice too many questions. There are fixed pattern questions. The question will be framed exactly like this. There is no variation possible. Okay, in RCC, you don't have to worry about any variation. Just practice the normal type of questions. Okay. So let's start solving this question. Okay. First question that he has asked is to determine MCR, okay, cracking moment. You already know if cracking starts, it will start somewhere here at the bottom. Okay, if you have this section, this is the point, say I'm calling it A, this is the point where cracking will start. So this is where we want to evaluate the stress. So you already know the mechanism how we solve for cracking moment. We'll start. What you will do simply is you should just draw the transformed section. First of all, let's draw the transformed section. Suppose this is your section. This is your section. Somewhere here the steel was. So you will do this. You will provide additional area. Okay. This additional area you have provided. Okay. Now your neutral axis is somewhere here. Okay. Neutral axis is somewhere here. Where is the neutral axis in this case? It's located at the CG of section. What section? Transformed section. Okay, now this most of the things we have already done. I'm just writing a dimension here. This is your 300, this is your 600 overall depth, this effective depth here is 550. Okay, this area here. Okay, from now on I will call this blank area as A1 and this checked area as A2. Let's calculate these areas. Okay, you already know this area is M minus 1 into AST. Okay, now A1 is equal to how much? 300 into 600. That is 18 into 10 to the power 4 mm square. Okay. A2, I have already told you, it is M minus 1 AST, that is equal to, what is M? In one of the assumptions, I have told you that M is equal to 280 upon 3 sigma CVC. Okay, now you will ask me that this value is not given. I have already told you that the factor of safety is nearly 3. So you are given with M20 concrete, so your sigma CBC is nearly 20 by 3, that is 6.67. You round it off and you take it as 7. Okay, your sigma CBC value is 7. So your M will come out to be 280 by 3 sigma CBC is equal to 280 by 3 into 7. If you solve this, you will get 13.3. Okay, So here m is 13.3 minus 1. What is your AST? AST in this section, AST is given as 425 bars. So we have 425 bars, so it is 4, and the area of one bar is pi by 4, 25 square. Okay, you can calculate this. I have already calculated this. So this value will come out to be 24138.75 mm square. Okay, 24138.75 mm square. Now we have the values. Now we have the values of A1 is 18 into 10 to the power 4, and your A2 is equal to 24138.75 mm square. Okay, this is also mm square. Okay, so one thing is done. Second thing that we have to do is the location of CG of individual areas, that is x1 and x2. Why we are doing this? Because we want to find the CG of section A1 x1 plus A2 x2 upon A1 plus A2. This is what we want to find out, and that is why we are calculating A1, A2, x1 and x2. So x1 is very simple. Let me change the color here. Let me say blue. So this blank section, this white section that you are seeing, the CG of this white section will be somewhere here. Somewhere here. Okay? At the middle. So this distance you already know, it is 300, because the whole depth is 600. 600 upon 2, that is 300. And the CG of this shaded area is this much only. That is, we have already known, it is 550. So now you know the value of x1. X1 is 300 and x2 is 550. You substitute these values here. 18 into 10 to the power 4 into 330 plus, okay, plus your 24138.7 into 550, okay, divided by 18 into 10 to the power 4 plus 24138.7. okay, you can calculate this value. I have already calculated it. It will come out to be 329.5 mm. This is your neutral axis. So one important job is already done. We have transformed the section, and now we know where the neutral axis is. Okay, so this was a transformed section. Okay, this was our section, this was our section. Okay, now we have calculated the neutral axis. Okay, now we have calculated the neutral axis somewhere here. This value we have calculated just now, 329.5. This value you can calculate. 600 minus 329.5, it will come out to be 270.5, I think. Okay, check it once. Now what do we want? We want stress at point A. Okay, we want sigma A. We already know from flexure formula, it is equal to m by I into ya. What are the things that we have? What are the things that we have? We have this y. This y will be equal to 270.5. Inertia is one thing that we don't have. So next thing that we want to move forward and calculate is inertia of this section. Okay, this section. Let me write down the dimensions. Okay, this is your 550. So inertia, we have already sorted out inertia. We will divide it into two areas. One is this shaded area, the other one is the blank area, and we'll add inertia of individually. Okay, I1 will be equal to how much? I1, 300 into b d cube by 12. Okay, plus 300 into 600. Okay, this is the area into, this is the center or CG axis of blank area. So we want this distance, that is equal to how much? 29.5. okay, I am writing it here, 329.5 minus 300 square, ax square. This is nothing but icg, icg plus ax square. Okay, this second area, shaded area, is only line area, so you only need the area. Area we already know, here is the area 24138.7 into x. What is x? This is x. Okay, from this area to this neutral axis. Okay, that is equal to how much? 270.5 minus 50. So I'm writing here 270.5 minus 50 square. This is simply ax square. Okay, this is the total inertia. You can calculate it. I have already calculated it. It will come out to be 65.73 into 10 to the power 6 mm to the power 4. Okay, I think now we have everything. For cracking, what we are having? We are having sigma is greater than sigma rupture. So your sigma cracking is equal to how much? 0.7 under root FCK. That is equal to 0.7 under root 20. If you calculate this, it will come out to be 3.13 MPa. So if your sigma at A is greater than this rupture, your A will crack. That is what we want. Now you put the value of sigma A. Sigma A is equal to M Y A by I is greater than sigma CR. Okay, this implies M Y A we know. Y is 270.5. I also we know, just now we have calculated, okay, is greater than sigma CR. Also we have calculated this value here, so it is 3.13 MPa. Can you put these values and calculate M? It's very simple, straightforward. You will get this M rupture, I am saying, that will be equal to 76.06 into 10 to the power 6 Newton mm, or rather I can say 76.06 kilonewton meter. This is your answer. This is the moment if you apply a moment of 76.06 kilonewton meter, your section will crack. Okay, so I think this is the first part of the question that we have solved, cracking moment. Okay, if you apply this much moment, your section will crack. What is the second part of the question? Okay, the second part of the question is asking what stress in steel and concrete for M equal to 50. Okay, simple. Okay, now he's saying, in second part he's saying that you have applied a moment of 50. Okay, what is the stress in concrete and stress in steel? Concrete means extreme fiber and steel means at the level of steel. Okay, now clearly you can say that your applied moment is less than cracking, so your section remains uncracked. Is this okay? Just now we have calculated this value as 76.06 kilonewton meter. You have applied only 50, so your section is uncracked. Since your section is uncracked, we don't have to do anything. Just we want to calculate sigma c. We can directly say sigma c by yc is equal to, or rather I will say y top. Okay. Now sigma c, he has asked stress in concrete, but he has not told us any location. So if he has not told any location, we are expecting that he is asking at extreme fiber, here or here. Okay, extreme fiber he is asking. So let us call this 1 and let us call this 2. We have already calculated everything. This is 329.5, this is 270.5. okay, so if I am calculating sigma 1, you will get M by I into Y1. M applied moment is 50, your y1 is this value. Okay, from neutral axis to top, this value is y1. So it is equal to 329.5 divided by, okay, divided by inertia. We already know how much is your inertia, 65.7 10 to the power 8 mm power 4. I think I have okay, yeah, this I have made a mistake here, corrected. It is 10 to the power 8, okay, 65.7 10 to the power 8. So you will get some value here. Sigma 1 will come out to be, okay, sigma 1 will come out to be 2.50, okay, you will get this value as 2.50 MPa. Okay, similarly you can calculate sigma 2 also. Sigma 2 will be equal to m by I into y2, that is equal to 50 into 10 to the power 6 newton mm. Okay, y2 is equal to 270.5 mm divided by 65.7 10 to the power 8 mm the power 4. So your sigma 2 will come out to be, I have already calculated this, 2.05 MPa. One answer is this. So we know the stress in concrete. Stress in concrete must be clear. The tricky part, or where people usually make a mistake, is you have to calculate the stress in steel. Okay, this much is how much, this value, it is 270.5 minus 50. Where is this 50 coming from? I think this is your 50, this part, this is your 270.5. I want this value, so this is right, that will come out to be 220.5. okay, now I want to calculate sigma at this point, 3, sigma 3. Simply by flexure formula I will say it is equal to this much value, isn't it? Now m I know, y3 just calculated, 220.5, inertia also I know, okay, so you should get the value. Okay, sigma 3 will come out to be, okay, 1.67 MPa. Now most people, what they do in hurry, they report this as answer, but it, this is not your answer, okay, this is not your answer. What is this value? What is sigma equal to 1.67 MPa? What is this value? Okay, sigma 3 you have got 1.67 MPa. Let me tell you what this is. This is the stress in concrete, okay, it is not the stress in steel, at level of steel. That means this is the level, this is the level where steel was located. At this level the stress in concrete is this much. So you can very easily say, what is the stress in steel at this level? It is m times of stress in concrete, that is 13.3 into 1.67. okay, 13.3 into 1.67, it will come out to be 22.3 MPa. This is your answer. Another observation, let me tell you another observation, okay, another important observation you can see from here. The steel that you have used is Fe415. It can take a permissible stress of how much? 140 MPa, isn't it? You are using dia less than, greater than 20, so 130 MPa. It can take a stress of say 130 MPa. How much is it actually taking? 22 MPa. Your steel has a capacity, to take 130 MPa of stress, but it takes only 22.3 MPa. Okay, this is because your section is uncracked. Once your section is cracked, steel will take higher load. Since it is uncracked, this is the reason we want our section to crack. crack means not big crack, just hairline cracks we what we want, so that the concrete below neutral axis fails and your steel start taking load up to its capacity. Otherwise your steel is underutilized. Okay, underutilized. So this point you should keep in mind. This is the second part that we have covered. Moving on to the third part of the question. Third part of the question, what is he saying in the third part? In third part he is saying stress in steel and concrete for M equal to 140. Now this is a good question and this is an important one. Okay, this is your third part. Applied moment now is 140. You know that your applied moment is greater than cracking moment. Your cracking moment was 76 something, this is 140, so your section is cracked. Okay, your section is cracked. Since your section is cracked, neutral axis calculation will be done on the basis of equilibrium forces, that is compression equal to tension. Okay, let's do that. I think we have already covered the equation. I think we have already evaluated the equation, no need to solve it again. We can directly take that equation. Okay, this is your equation. This is your equation. Okay, from here you can take. I will write the basic FCBC by 2 DXU is equal to FST into AST. Okay, and then we used this triangle, these two triangles we used. This is your FCBC, this is your XU. Okay, this is your D minus XU. Okay, and this is your FST by M. We used this and we came to this conclusion. Okay, we came to this conclusion, 2 AST by BXU is equal to XU upon M times of D minus XU. I think I have written this correctly. Okay, we have already derived this. You can look at the previous part of this video and you can tell us this is the equation. Now we know everything. What everything we know? We know this AST, we know B, we know M, we know D. Only thing that we don't know here is XU. It can be calculated. It can be calculated. So let's put the value 2 into, what is your AST? Your AST is 425 5 bars. What is your B? B is 300. X you want, X, this is 13.3. Your D is 550 minus XU. If you multiply this here and this here, what you will get? You will get something like this. 2 into 4 into pi by 4, 25 square, 13.3, 550 minus XU is equal to 300 XU square. Is this a quadratic equation? Quadratic equation. Okay, is this a quadratic equation? So what is the value of XU that you will obtain here? I have already done it. You can solve the quadratic equation and you can evaluate this. Your neutral axis will come out to be, your neutral axis will come out to be 234.61 mm. Is this okay? This is quadratic equation. You solve the quadratic equation from calculator and you get this value, 234.61. Now your section has been cracked. Your section is looking something like this. Here some steel was there. Okay, here is your neutral axis. You will transform this section, it will look like this. This here you will transform the steel into concrete. This is your concrete now. Okay, and this part of concrete is contributing in compression. If you draw the force diagram, it will look something like this. Okay, here you will have some tension. It will be equal to FST by M into MAST, and this will be your compression value. Okay, this top part will be XU by 3 and your lever arm will be d minus x u by 3. This part we have already done, theory part we have done. All you want now